Welcome to Ingedames. My name is Matthijs, and today is my guest Thomas van Doorn, who is a mitochondrial expert, and we want to discuss the latest interview, Brian Rose and David Icke. Number three, to be exact. Thomas, what was your first reaction after seeing that insane interview of, what is it, 3.5 hours
of pure magic? Yeah, 3 hours and 5 minutes or something like that. Yeah, incredible interview, man. Lots of knowledge there. Lots to think about as well. The end of the message was pretty nice to hear as well, that it's all about love. And for some people that sounded fake, but the way he explained it was not only fake, but it was also, it was really from the bottom of his heart. And yeah, he explained it really nice. So yeah, great interview, man. I watched it, a lot of people in my environment watched it.
Yeah.
From all types of groups and religions, and everybody liked it. So yeah.
And what was your biggest takeaway on the interview, or what struck you the most?
What struck me the most was the explanation about the fact that we're all electrical beings. So you and I, we have electrical signals running through our brain. And why that struck with me the most is because I get a lot of questions about, but why is non-native electromagnetic fields, why are they bad for you? What are they doing with you? And he explained it, quite nice. So yeah, your brain is electrical, the heart works with an electrical signal. And if there's a not natural electrical signal, extremely dominant in the way we are living now, and with the satellites and with the 5G that's coming up, and it's getting more and more and more, that is going to affect your electrical signal. So it's going to affect your physical state, but also your mental state. And the way you explained that, that really struck with me. Yeah, that was really nice.
And if you could add any explanation on that matter, about the electromagnetic part of David Icke, what could you add? Because I know it is in your specialism to know lots of stuff, because it affects the mitochondria, thus it affects the energy production of your human cells, thus it implicates that it has an effect on your health, because if no energy is being created, your molecule, your cells is not being able to send the right signals to other cells in the body.
Yeah, so to make it a little bit more simple is, the powerhouse of our cell, where the energy production in the form of ATP is made, is called mitochondria. Your heart, your brain, every cell in there has more than 2,500 mitochondria in there. That's normal, because you need a lot of energy in those areas, in your brain and in your heart especially. In every human cell, but especially in those two areas. So let's make it simple. You're having an oven, and you're putting something in that oven, let's say a steak, for example, and you put that steak in that oven, and that steak that needs to be cooked in the way you like it to have a certain outcome. And for that outcome, you need certain type of input, in this case, from the oven, certain type of temperature. If the temperature is way too low or way too high, you don't have the outcome that you want. We are built, we are made, or evolution, or by God, or whatever you like, to have a certain type of input, electrical input, from the sun, from the earth, and that creates a certain type of outcome, energy production in this case. And you need certain type of energy production to be healthy, to be alive, physically and mentally. If we are going to change the temperature of the oven where we live in, the oven, our oven is the earth and the sun and everything there. If there's going to be another frequency there, it's already there, but it's becoming more and more and more. The outcome of that steak, or in our case, that energy production, is going to be different. And researchers show that it's negative. So you're not able to produce the amount of energy that you need to be healthy. And 85 to 90% of all modern Western diseases start with an energy production failure. So the frequencies from 5G are different, not natural. They're going to be surrounding us. So we are living in an oven where we're not built for, where the temperature in that oven is not the normal way we're evolved around. So the outcome is going to be a fucked up steak every time again. And to translate it to the human body, your cell is going to be fucked up or not working the way it's supposed to be. And that results in a lack of energy production. A lack of energy production lacks in not optimal health.
Right. So the most easy part of not getting fucked up, for that matter, is go walk in a forest.
Yeah, for example,
plug EMF.
Yeah, we are product of nature. So if you reconnect with nature again, then the input out of that environment, from the sun, from the Earth's magnetic field, from temperature, from air, everything like that, we are built to pick up that signal, and from there on, our internal program or internal software knows what to do. But if you disconnect from normal software or normal input to program the software, then yeah, there's going to be a problem with the hardware. And the hardware in this case will be your organs or your cells. So, and that was another really interesting explanation he had. And he also made it simple that an oven or a microwave has vibrations, and the vibrations of 5G, especially the 60 gigahertz, do something to an oxygen molecule. So it changes the oxygen molecule. Now, you don't have to be a scientist to know that you need oxygen for an optimal life or to be healthy in general. And that vibration changes oxygen in a negative way. And it's not David Icke who's the first to say that. There's loads of research. There are people who are winning a Nobel Prize in 1952. Gilbert Ling is his name. For the explanation, the scientific physics explanation on how this stuff works and how electromagnetic fields can be negative. Of course, there's a lot of positive stuff from it as well. I mean, we're Skyping now at the moment, but there are also negative side effects from it.
So, and maybe a bit more personal, but when you listen to something like that, do certain things scare you?
Yes and no. It's always been a certain type of fear that creates power as well. So what he explains there is that fear is not helping you. You know, a lot of times it's fake as well. So I see it more as motivation to continue and keep educating people about health, what health is, how you can reach it. It's not that hard. So no, of course, it can be scary in a way that you and I don't have the control over certain type of things. Other people do have that control and they can harm you and the effects will be negative. But the way you deal with it, that's the way the outcome is going to be. So can be, but for a couple seconds, and then immediately the fear changes to power and the experience that everything is going to be fine if you have that mentality. You don't have to fear stuff like that.
And that sounds more like in a generalistic state of mind. But how for you exactly personal? How personal did David went yesterday for you?
Yeah, extremely personal, because especially the part about consciousness. That's what I'm about. That's what we try to teach at Your Health Concept, that there is more that you can see, there's more than you can smell, there's more than you can hear, and that is affecting you. And if you connect with that, you can call it God, you can call it nature, you can call it the universe. If you connect with that, there are possibilities beyond imagination. And for a lot of people, that sounds a little bit woo-hoo or too Buddha-like or yoga-like. No, but that stuff is out there. That those energies, I always call it energies, are out there and they're affecting me. If you connect with those energies, you know what to do. You know your purpose. And so, yeah, really personal, because he was really the example.
Albert Einstein, he called it the field.
Yeah. And Albert Einstein also said the future of medicine will be frequencies. That's why he was always interested in that stuff. Like, there are certain types we don't see, but they are there. I mean, electrons, protons, photons, yep. Everything Einstein did, we cannot see it, but it's there and it's having an impact on us. And that goes for same for the stuff David Icke is talking about. So yeah, really personal. That's my passion, to teach other people about this stuff and how they can let it in and let them heal the physical body, but the mental body as well. And I'm really glad it's not that woo or weird or an alternative type of, yeah, how do you say, looking at nature. No, it's just scientifically based.
All right. And what about the lizard people?
Yeah, that's one of the specialties of David Icke as well. I really don't know much about it. I read about it, but yeah, I don't know. I really don't know. Absolutely. No,
I don't know either, but maybe I think he spoke about the ways religion speaks about these beings. But then again, everything he says, I've never studied it myself, except for a small part of what electromagnetic fields do to your mitochondria and cell membrane. So I think I can have a small opinion on that matter. But furthermore, I think I can just sit down and listen and feel if stuff resonates with me.
Yeah, same goes for me. I don't know anything about lizard people. Of course, I read some books and some stuff, but that's just small. Yeah, we don't know shit, and he doesn't know shit, but he explains that he doesn't know shit. So, and that and that resonates with me as well, to be humble about that. You try to help other people, and that's the best thing you can do, and that's what some people call love. Other people have a different name for it, but for me, that's love. Try to help other people in every way you can. And that was what really resonated with me. Same goes for Brian Rose. Same goes for David Icke. It looks like, and it feels like, and it hears like that they truly want to help other people. And that's what love is to me.
Yeah. I think for me, love is to be and to let be. And I know you have to teach. So, and the goal of this interview was to keep it short. And how can people find you?
You can find us yourhealthconcept.nl. You can find us on Facebook and Instagram. We're not banned yet, so let's see how that plays out. But yeah, you can find us on social media at yourhealthconcept.
All right, thank you very much, Thomas.
Thank you, man. Have a good day.
Enjoy the day.
Bye bye.